are going to show you our advanced frequency modulation and demodulation trainer kit. Order code is 40519. So this is the trainer kit. You can see there are 12 blocks are here. This is the false switch. So whenever you do the any experiments, keep this false switch in off condition. This is an AF modulation signal generator. This is the amplitude potentiometer and this is the frequency potentiometer. This is the block 2. Block 3 is quadrature detector. Block 4 is detuned resonance circuit, this one. Block 5 is reactance modulator. Block 6 is mixer and amplifier. Here the switch is given to select between reactance and varactor. Block 7 is Foster-Seeley ratio detector. So here also a switch is given to choose between A by S or ratio. This is phase locked loop detector. Here also a switch is given to select on position or off position. This is varactor modulator. This is the potentiometer for varactor modulator. This is block 10. This one is amplitude limiter and this one is low pass filter. Also you can see in block 10, this is the modulator block, this is the modulator input and here is the modulated output. With this, user manual and patch cards are included, and to do this experiment we will need a CRO or DSO to observe the output waveform. Our first experiment is varactor modulator. Here the procedures are given step by step. And this is the connection that we need to make to perform this experiment. So first, connect sine output here to this audio input and this to this. To the audio input of varactor modulator. Now we will check the output waveform. So first we will check the modulating signal here. So this is the signal, this is our modulating signal and select this switch to varactor mode, so this reactance mode will be blocked. So now the output signal from the varactor modulator appears at this test point T50. So check the output waveform here. This is the output waveform. You can check the output waveform. But due to any capacitive loading, we will check the output here from mixer amplifier to at T34. You can see the output, adjust the potentiometer at this block, mixer amplifier block like this. this potentiometer and we can check the output. You can see that this is a sine wave. Also from here you can check the VPP. This is our FM carrier. Now also you can check various output waveform with this test point given here, like this. This I have checking this waveform at T32, this is at T33, this is at T26. So if you want, you can check the waveform, different types of waveform at this different type, at this different number of test points given here. Our next experiment is reactance modulator. For this, the connection is same, just select this switch to reactance mode. So first we will check the modulating signal here at T2. This is the modulating signal. Now the output waveform appears here at point T20. So check the waveform here. This is the waveform. But so we can check the waveform here at T20, but due to capacity loading we will again check the waveform at this point T34. So this is the output waveform. Using this potentiometer, you can get a clean waveform. Now you can from here you can see that the VPP is around 1.3 volt and the frequency is around almost 400 kilohertz. Now by adjusting this potentiometer you can adjust the frequency around 400 kilohertz. Our next experiment is quadrature detector. This is the circuit diagram that we are going to build for this experiment. So first connect sine output here at audio input. And connect audio input here at, connect audio input with audio input at the varactor modulator. Select the switch at varactor modulator. Connect this quadrature detector input with mixer amplifier output and connect this output, quadrature detector output, with low pass filter input. Now we will observe the waveform at T10, and after that we will observe the final output waveform at T78. So check the output at TP10. This is the output waveform. This output waveform contains three components: a positive DC offset voltage, sine wave at the same frequency as the audio signal, and a high frequency ripple component of small amplitude. Now, check the output at T72. Now check the output at T78. This is the low pass filter amplifier block. This strongly attenuates the high frequency ripple component at the detector's output and also blocks the DC offset voltage. Consequently, the signal at the output of low pass filter should very closely resemble the original audio modulating signal.